Bring on the Coast Guards. We can't get away with that box now. We'd never be able to get out of the harbor.
What are you going to do?
Take it to the river warehouse until I can figure out a plan to smuggle it out of the country.
Brown, get that suitcase out of the boat.
Get the small boat ready.
Yes, sir.
Now, here's what I want you to say if anybody comes aboard asking questions. Bob!
On board with some friends, and
then they started shooting my plane full of holes. Why?
I've no idea. Though I did hear them say something about an attack.
Find out anything, Jim?
No, whoever was here made a clean getaway.
Put in the Coast Guard dock.
Yes, sir.
Have one of the boys check on him tomorrow.
Right.
You better hurry to Mallory's and have him construct another neometer so we can find that box. If the foreign agents smuggle it out of this country, it might mean war.
I'd call up the army and round up these spies.
Create a fine international incident.
No, these things have to be done undercover.
That's just the trouble. You don't give me anything worth writing a story about.
Had a good one about that Navy plane that crashed last night.
Mm-hmm. And my editor broke me out because I couldn't tell him who it was or what they were trying to do.
Why not let her break the story about our belief that Zorka is still alive?
Can't see what good that would do. Anyway, we're not sure of it ourselves.
The only explanation for the things that have been happening.
That's right, Bob. Remember the mechanical Iron Man and how things are always being taken by something invisible.
I'm still not sure. Anyway, I've got Max stationed at Zorka's house for any clue that Zorka is still alive.
Are you sure there was another man in that office where you got that box?
Certainly, I saw him.
If you remember, I suspected some time ago that Zorka might not be dead. And things have happened since to verify that suspicion. The office was taken under the name of Zane. Note the Z, as in Zorka. Also the fact that it must be someone very familiar with his work.
We can easily find out. The two of them are still locked up in the vault there.
If it is Zorka, we can send both him and his secret to our country. It will save us endless time in learning how to use whatever it is he has invented.
I'll bring them both down here. You can make that fellow Monk talk anyway.
Did you put the box in the river warehouse?
Yes. Harlan's going to analyze its contents, if he ever gets up nerve enough to open it.
Make me one of those belts, Dr. Zorka, so I can make myself invisible, too. If you don't, the cops will get me sure, and I'll spend the rest of my life in jail.
There's no time for that.
Besides, I need someone to draw suspicion for myself.
What we do? We can't go back to our office in that building now that they know it's there.
You forget I can go back unseen. Take the car and hide it in our secret garage and wait for me in the laboratory.
How are you going to get there?
Never mind that. The important thing is to find out what they have done with my meteorite.
The chief had the right hunch.
What's that?
Zarka's still alive. Whoever worked his way out of that vault had plenty on the ball.
Well, he'll never find that box of his where we've got it hidden in the warehouse.
If it was Zarka, he'd head back to his laboratory. We'll look that place over. Better go in separate cars. You take the south road. We'll meet at Zarka's.
That, will you, Bob?
Yeah? Yeah. All right, Mac, we'll be right out. Mac says the car just arrived at Zarka's house. He thinks some of the foreign agents were in it. Say, Jean comes back, keep her here.
We'll run into him there.
Another carload have come since I phoned you.
We'll close in and see what's going on.
What puzzles me is that they've got the box. What do they want here?
They probably have the same hunch we have, that Zorka's still alive. You stay here, Mac. Keep your eyes open.
Yes, sir.
Now we will learn what they have done with my precious element.
Maybe I can see him.
See anything?
Well, I can't see anything, but I can hear them.
Well, there's nobody in this part of the house. That's a cinch.
If we find the old boy, do we take him to the same place we did in the box?
Yeah, it's handed to the pier. Chief wants to ship them both out of the country as soon as possible.
What do you mean, handed to the pier? It's a half mile from the waterfront.
Oh, you're thinking about the other joint. I mean the old warehouse across from the Green Star pier.
Pipe down, both of you.
We have tricked them into revealing the hiding place of our meteorite.
Get in your car, Mac, and watch them. They leave trail.
Yes.
Now I shall punish them for robbing me.
Mac.
see that they are all destroyed. I must go to that warehouse.
Well, let's get out of here.
The place over there.
Let's find out. Come on, quit stalling. Where's that box?
In the experimental lab. But the door's locked and...
Wait a minute, Claude.
Come on, you. Don't make a sound because I'll be right outside.
You've beaten us to it.